Air conditioning. How does it work? By a guy who read half a Wikipedia article about it. If you're living in pretty much anywhere in the Northern Hemisphere apart from the IKEA region and the Vodka region, you'll see that over the past few days it's been getting hot. One of the ways we combat the hot is by this new thing called air conditioning. They make a room cold, but how does one make something cold? No, really. What is cold? In order to make something cold, you simply just need to remove energy from it. Sounds relatively simple, right? No. Before humans got smart, we'd use snow and ice to make things cold, which although got the job done, had this weird side effect of making everywhere wet. So we just said fuck this, and we created mechanical cooling. In the year 1758, some guy you've probably never heard of turns to his friend John and goes, Hey, get this. What if we put some alcohol on top of this thing, blow on it, see what happens? And they blew air on some alcohol they put on a thermometer, and they saw that the temperature went down to negative 14 degrees Celsius. After observing this with his friend, Benjamin is quoted saying, "From this experiment, one may see the possibility of freezing a man to death on a warm summer's day." Benjamin and John didn't get along very well after that day. Then, a couple of decades later, Faraday decides, what if, instead of just letting alcohol evaporate, we don't do that? Then he does exactly that, and soon he discovers that compressing and liquefying ammonia could chill the air when the liquefied ammonia is allowed to evaporate. Soon after, some Florida man steals his idea to get a patent about an ice-making machine. But, being a Florida man, he didn't have enough money to get anything done, so the project died down. And with it, the field of air conditioning will be stalled for another 30 years. But, 30 years later, his dreams will be accomplished by a different Australian. Harrison decides to steal the stolen idea and make money off of it while doing that. So, he established a commercial ice-making machine. And, to be honest, he didn't really steal the idea. In fact, he actually improved upon it, but the patent actually came after the machine started making sweet, sweet ice money. We now move back to the States, to New York. The first air conditioner as you know today is designed and built. But this was no ordinary air conditioning. No. Not only did this newfangled AC make the room colder, it also controlled the humidity. And in a way, it really just conditioned the air. But jolly goodness, how do they do this? Again, how do you make air cold? Well, how do you make it hot in the first place? You just send air through some hot coils and boom, you got hot air. Well, why don't we instead make the coils colder and get cold air? This was a brilliant idea. In fact, it was so brilliant they had to found the Carrier Air Conditioning Company of America in order to meet the demand. Then, some years later in Minneapolis, they realized, you know that AC thing we have in our factories and they make cold air? Well, what if they still made cold air but instead of cooling a workplace, they would cool a living place? And thus, the air conditioning technology has finally been brought to the housing market. Now you may be thinking, that's good and all, but you never really answered the question of how does one make something cold. Well, it's simple, let's recap. So far we have established that when you blow air through something cold, like ice, it makes the air cold. And when you put something that you can evaporate later on top of a heat conductor, it also makes it cold. So you can use things such as liquefied ammonia to let that happen. And finally, instead of doing the whole ammonia business, you can just take something, compress it, and evaporate it later on some coil to maximize surface area, and then pass air through the now cold coil to make the room cold. If for some reason you like this content and would like to see more things like, I don't know, history of refrigeration, history of ovens, or you know, fancy stuff like those, be sure that you are tuned in for the next week's episode of Weird Shit, Less Weirdified. Thanks for watching.